Let's look at the depth limited search, the DLS algorithm. Here we've got a tree as an example. And here we're going to do a depth limited search. The limit is 2. So you can see here we've got an unbalanced tree. The left hand side has a lot of elements and the right hand side doesn't have many. So when we have an unbalanced tree like this, the depth first search is going to go through a lot of elements before it gets to the right hand side tree, for example. So we can limit the search. So here we're going to limit at level 2. So we only go down to level 2. We still use the same approach as the depth first search. So let's go through the nodes. We go to number 1, the root node, then 2, then 4, then stop at that depth, then 3, then 5. That's the depth limited search. Another example, here we've got a limit of 3, so level 3. So we stop there, that's level 3. So we've got 1, 2, 4, 6, 7 and 8, and then 3 and 5. So you could see we have a limit on how far we go down, but we use the same approach as the depth first search. Here's a slightly different example. Here we're looking at the path. We're still going to use a limit of 2 on the depth, but we're looking at the paths rather than individual nodes. So we stop at this limit at level 2, and we can look, we've got CAP, we've got COT, and then the final one, there's no ending of the path at our limit. So that means that we stop here. So we've got CAP and COT, but we don't look at CHIME and CHIP because they go further than our limit on the depth. Now, what about a task? Well, in previous videos, we've looked at a graph. Now, we've looked at breadth first search and depth first search. What about depth limited search? We'll carry on with the limit of level 2. So remember this graph, we're going from left, number 1, through to the right hand side, the ends element with number 10. So can you find which nodes and which order these elements will be visited, these nodes will be visited using a depth limited search? We'll see the answer shortly. You can use the graph or a directed graph, the answer's the same. Let's have a look at an example where we're going to implement the depth limited search with a stack. So it's very similar to the depth first search. We start off the root node 1, and then we're going to put in the elements 10, 9 and 2 in reverse order into the stack. Then we're going to pop out 2, and we're going to put the 4 and 3 in the reverse order. Then we're going to pop 3, pop 4, pop 9, and then pop 10. So we end up with the order 1, 2, 3, 4, 9 and 10. So that's how we do a depth limited search using a stack. Having a look at the code. Well, although we're using the example of a tree, we're going to implement the code as if it was a graph. So a tree is a type of graph. A graph is not a type of tree, but a tree is a type of graph. So we can use the same code for a tree as we do for a graph. So here we've defined the tree, and here's our code. It's very similar to what we've done with our depth first search. So should we have a look at our code in the Python editor? We start off with the depth first search code we used on the graph. You may recognize this from the previous video. Now we need to change this. First of all, change the actual graph, which is a tree. A tree is a type of graph. And here we've got the depth limit. So we pass this. We can see we're using the same code, but we have the depth and we have the depth limit. So we can stop once that limit's reached, and We can add to that depth when we add children, which in this case with the graph are neighbors. So when we run that code, you could see we have the order 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, and 10. Let's run it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, and 10. So that's the code when we apply it on the tree. So you can see here the output of our stack and the order 1, 2, 3, 4, 9, and 10 from our slides and the code. Now what about the task? We had a graph, didn't we? So we want a depth limited search limit of 2. So here's our graph. We need graph traversal. So here's our graph. We can help understand this by looking at what we've seen already. In the previous videos, we saw the breadth first search, which remember, we looked at the elements in this order. Then we did the depth first search, which we can look at how we traverse this graph. You can see the paths that we used here. So hopefully you see the previous video. And now the depth limited search, we have the same graph. We're going to start off 1, goes to 2, to 4, to 7, to 5, to 3, to 6. So we don't visit the other nodes because we had a limit of level 2. That's where we stopped. So that's the order of the elements we visit in the graph traversal with this graph. Let's have a look at the code. Well, it's the same as what we've seen already. Here are the edges of the graph that we've just traversed. Here is the code. It's exactly the same code, except the graph defined on the right-hand side. So it's pretty much the same code. We can change our code we used on the tree to use on the graph that we've seen previously in the task by just changing the actual graph itself. So the code is the same as before, as we showed with traversing the tree. And this, remember, depth limited search. We're going to run this and you can see the order 1, 2, 4, 7, 5, 3, 6. Run it again. 1, 2, 4, 7, 5, 3, 6. So the only thing that we've changed here from the previous code is the actual definition of the graph, the edges from each node. So we can apply the same code to trees and graphs because trees are a form of graphs. So trees are a form of graph, although slightly limited. So that's the code for our depth limited search. There is a great new opportunity for anyone interested in learning about Python or any other areas of computing. In the next year, new courses will be added to the ALPS Academy, and they will be available to you for free. Written by university professors, they will be specifically designed for international students, which means they'll be easy to understand using simple language. They will even be helped to improve your English, if you're interested. How can this help you? Well, leave a comment. Any suggestions you make could be turned into a course. Motivated learners deserve equal access to opportunities. Help us to help you. Okay, if you like that video, please click the like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. We'll be following this video with more searches we get in AI.